Sophie and I'm a teacher at Art Sphere. It's a windy day, so I'm going to be showing you how to make your very own pair of wind chimes using objects you find in nature and around the house. Alrighty, let's get started! To make these wind chimes, you'll need three basic elements. You'll need something to hold the wind chimes from, you'll need objects to construct the wind chimes out of, and you'll need some sort of tying material to hold it all together. In the following few clips, we'll explore the different types of objects that you can use for this project. The first thing you're going to need is something to support your wind chimes. There are a bunch of different things you could use for this. You could use a stick you find outside. I believe this is from a sycamore tree that I found earlier today. You could also use a piece of scrap wood. This is an old paint stick I have from an earlier project. You could even use something like a coat hanger or a piece of wire, really anything sturdy that can support the weight of all of your chimes. The next thing you'll need is something to hold your chimes together with. For this project, I used twine just because I had it lying around. But you could also use a number of other things like yarn or string or even some sort of fishing line or a wire if you have it lying around. Lots of things work for this project. The next thing you'll need is something for the middle of your chime that'll create a nice resonant sound with the other elements of the chimes. I used a Coca-Cola bottle for this project, mostly because I like the color of it and the shape. I think that's really pretty and interesting looking, but you can use plenty of other things. You can use aluminum cans, you could use a mixture of small Tabana paste sized cans or the normal size aluminum cans and play around with how they clang together and how they knock around while they're swinging on your chimes. So, once you find something to hold up your chimes with, something to tie all together with, and a main piece for the middle of your wind chime, then you're going to want to fill it out with a bunch of fun found objects. So here I've got some pine cones, I've got some walnut shells, I've got some tin foil, I've got some pencils, I've got some keys. The main goal is to use a mix of found objects that you find outside and inside. So, what are some of the cool things I found on my scavenger hunt for wind chime pieces?
Objects found in nature. Some Norway spruce cones, some red spruce cones, some hemlock cones, some white pine cones, some white spruce cones, I think, some red pine cones, a shortleaf pine cone, and a pitch pine cone. I also found some black walnuts, some sweet gum tree pods, a coffee tree pod, a Chinese chestnut, ouchie, those things are spiky. Finally, some red oak acorns. Other things you can use for this project are twigs, all sorts of twigs, and rocks, make them small. Here are some objects you might find around the house to use for this project. Pop tabs, lids, tinfoil, washers, keychains, keys, silverware, little tiny pencil nubs, thimbles, clothespins, paper clips, other clips, loose change, and buttons.
The last thing you'll need is something to decorate your wind chimes with. If you have an acrylic paint on hand, that's great. This is a non-toxic water-based paint that will hold up well outside. But if you don't have acrylic paint, don't worry, there are a lot of other ways you can be creative with this project. You can use colored embroidery floss or yarn or something to tie around the different elements of your wind chimes. You could also even cut up some pieces of aluminum foil and wrap it around to have a metallic effect. So,
okay, what's next?
So, obviously, you're going to want to decorate the elements of your wind chime. This is a little black walnut. And so something you can do is paint them. So I recommend mixing a little bit of white paint with your colors because that'll add a little bit of opacity to it. And then you can just decorate them however you want. So I'm just gonna see how that looks. It's kind of fun, interesting. Yellow and some white in there.
So, that's one thing you can do. Another thing you can do is use the different types of thread or thing you have around there. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this. I will cut a piece off. And then I have my stick here. What you can do is have a little extra at the end so you have enough to tie off with. And then just wrap it around. Then another thing you can do is I like to take some tin foil and like here and here can add this as well. And maybe to finish off, I'll add more paint.
And with our finishing touches, we're ready to begin the next step.
So, now that you're finished decorating the different parts of your wind chime with your paint and your embroidery floss and your aluminum foil, it's time to start putting the wind chimes together. One thing that you want to keep in mind when you start assembling your wind chimes is that you're making sure that the items you're using make a cool sound with each other. So, you might want to practice seeing what different things sound when they hit each other. I'm going to take my walnut shell, clanging against my Coca-Cola bottle. I also have my little tin can here. Maybe I want to take a stick to do the same thing. Play around and experiment with this. Think of it as a little sound laboratory for the amazing wind chime that you're going to make. Once you play around with sound, you want to start putting the pieces of your wind chime together. So make sure you have all your little objects. So your walnut shells, your pine cones, your hardware, your clothing pins, etc. Take these little guys and you'll want to get your tying material to tie them all together. The goal is to end up with a bunch of different strands for your wind chimes. So for the one I made here, I have my middle Coca-Cola bottle right there. And then I have a bunch of different pieces coming off of it, as you can see, with some tin foil at the very ends. So you're gonna basically make a bunch of these guys. Oop, got a little knotted up. So in this one, I have my pine cone, I have a walnut shell, and I have a little washer and a pop tab that are I put right next to each other so they make a little jingly sound. You're going to want to make sure that you cut at least 25 inches of your twine off to begin with, so that way you won't run out of room to tie it to your final stick piece. So, have your twine, make sure it's long enough, get your scissors, cut a piece off, and start tying. So some of the items are a little bit trickier to tie than others. It's ideal if your item already has a hole in it. So that's why washers and things like paper clips are really great. Obviously, when you're using something like a walnut shell, it's a little bit trickier. So what I recommend doing is just making sure that you wrap the string around the object a bunch of times like this, and then double knotting it at the end. And that way the piece is going to stay on pretty well. You can just have one item on every string, or you can put multiple items together like I showed before. There's so many different variations to this wind chime design. So it's a good idea to sort of lay out your composition before you finish assembling everything together. Once you have all your strands like so, then you're going to be ready to start tying them on to your stick.
Now I want to talk for a little bit about tying up the bottles and cans, because this part can be a little bit trickier than tying up the rest of the elements. The main thing you're going to want to make sure is that when you're taking your yarn or twine, that you're wrapping it around the bottle or can several times so that it holds firmly. Then you're going to want to tie it off, definitely with a double knot. You're also going to want to leave a little bit of give around the bottle or can when you're doing this, because you'll need a little bit of extra room later to slide in some extra twine and yarn under the yarn that you're tying on now. As you can see, I was having a little bit of trouble with this, but eventually I do end up tying the knot and moving on to the next step. Once you're finished with that, you're going to want to take some separate pieces of twine and slide it under the loop that you've already tied around the bottle. This also took a little bit of time because I tied this initial part a little bit too tightly. Once you've done that, again, you're going to want to make sure that you're double knotting really carefully, and then you're going to flip the bottle over and you're going to do it again on the other side of the loop. I recommend doing at least 4 of these longer lines. That will help the bottle keep in place and not swing terribly crazy once you tie it to the main frame of your wind chime.
So once you finish tying up your Coca-Cola bottle or tin can or whatever else you're using, you should have something that looks roughly like this. As you can see, being held snugly in place, it won't be going anywhere anytime soon. And I left enough room at the top so that I'll have enough twine to tie off my bottle to the main frame of my wind chimes, which will be this stick. So I'm going to show you quickly how I do that. First, I made sure that the 4 different strands that were coming out of my bottle, I tied together right here, basically to consolidate them with a little knot. And then I'm going to take 2 of each of the strands, 2 on this side, 2 on this side, and I'm going to put my stick right in between. I want to tie this close towards the middle because this is kind of a heavy object, so I want to make sure that my wind chimes are balanced and aren't falling one way or the other. And I'm going to hold this between my legs really quickly. And just like all the other knots, so just a simple knot, we're going to double knot it, and that should hold it in place. I don't really know that many fancy knots, but I think this project would be a great time to learn some new knots, if that is something you're interested in. So there you have it. There's the middle part of my wind chime. Now what I'm gonna do is take the rest of my pieces, smaller parts that go around it, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna tie those on as well. So once I'm done doing that, I'll be able to hear the types of sounds that they make when all together. And look at that, that already sounds pretty cool. I'm pretty excited to have this wind chime be finished. All right, guys, once you have all your main pieces tied to your frame, your wind chimes are almost done. The last thing you have to do is tie a piece of twine to either end of your chimes so that you have something to hold your chimes up with. Then if you have a balcony or a yard or even just a window, you can hang up your chimes and you can listen to the different sounds they make throughout the day. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to make your own found object wind chimes. I certainly had a lot of fun doing this project. And at Arts Fair, we would love if you guys shared your projects with us. So again, I'm going to share the ArtSphere info, so you can check out our blog at www.artsphere.org/blog. You can follow us at ArtSphere Inc. on Twitter and Instagram. And as always, if you end up posting any of your pictures online, we'd love for you to use the hashtag #LoveArtSphereInc so we can see the amazing things you guys are making. As always, I hope you're staying safe and well, and I hope you have some time to enjoy making some wonderful wind chimes. Have a good one, guys. That's all from me.